to start working on the Turbo 400 swap in this. I talked briefly about it in the last video. I'm going to get the intake manifold off of this. I pulled the intake manifold off because it's way easier to get to the top valve housing bolts of the manifold out of the way. Okay, now that the intake manifold's off, quick show you why I did that. Grab my light, but check out how much easier it is to get to those valve housing bolts. Both of them right there, and the hose is in the way, but you get the idea of the other one right there. Makes that super easy, definitely worth the 20 minutes it took me to get the intake manifold off. So I'm gonna get this thing up on jack stands and start pulling the trans. All right, now that we got the transmission out of this thing, wanted to show you what I saw on the back of the converter. So this is, on the back side of this, is it's a lockup, it's a triple dish lockup. On the back side of here is where all the plates lock against the converter. You can see the discoloration ring in there. That's not definitely not supposed to be there. This being a triple disc, it should handle the 1100 horse or so I was pushing through it, which would tell me there's some sort of I wasn't applying enough pressure to the lockup. Doesn't really matter anymore since we're going to a Turbo 400, but I'll have to send this converter out and have Circle D go through it and freshen it up if I decide to sell it or keep it regardless. So, thought that was interesting. So let's check out our new stuff over here. So this is a Rossler Turbo 400. I actually bought this a few years ago for a different project that I just haven't got back to working on. It isn't the gear ratio that I really want to use in this car. It's a 165 first gear transmission. The car being 3,700 pounds, it's going to be pretty difficult to get the starting line ratio where I want. I might do a short video on starting line ratio stuff at some point, but yeah, so it's a Reed case, Reed mod motor valve. Like I said, it's a Rossler deal. It's got their dump valve on it. Obviously their trans brake eating stage. It's a clean neutral trans, 3-speed turbo 400. And then we got some JPC stuff. So this is their turbo 400 trans mount with the drive shaft tube integrated into it. This one bolt there, so I gotta pull the old drive shaft tube out of the car still. And a PTC converter, and another JPC sells this mod motor turbo 400 SFI flywheel. Or flex plate, rather. So we've got that stuff here too. So also, like I talked in the beginning of this, we're gonna do a mid plate. So I have the mid plate laying on the box still. I've traced it out onto the cardboard. I've gotta cut it out, and then we'll fit the cardboard into the car just to get the width correct. And I'm gonna have to cut a lot of these corners off of here to clear stuff like the steering shaft on this side and just how the frame is built in these. So I'm gonna get going on that. First thing I'm gonna do though is I'm going to test fit the converter, the new converter, into the trans. I have not done that yet. This is a 27 spline, I think it's an inch and 3/16 input shaft. So I'm gonna go ahead and test fit the converter into the transmission and go from there. I think fit right in there. Just always good to double check that stuff before we get too carried away here. So the other thing we got from JPC is this pilot adapter. This side goes in the back of the crankshaft. This is the normal GM diameter. So that we'll just go onto here. Make sure that fits. It does. It's a little tight. I'm probably gonna put a little bit more of a lead in here with just a chamfer tool. And then that'll be good. So all this stuff looks to be good and ready to go in. I'm gonna start fitting the mid plate and tackle that project, but wanted to check this stuff out before I got too carried away here. So all right, so I got the block plate all traced out on the cardboard. I'm going to go ahead and cut this thing out and start getting it trimmed up to go in the car. Thank you.
talk about the block plate and what its purpose is. For those of you that aren't familiar, a block plate is intended to prevent the twist of the engine from allowing the factory motor mount pickup points, which is in the center of the cylinder walls, well, in the center of the cylinder banks, to deform the block under serious load. I've actually seen recently an LS block with a factory motor mount pickup point actually remove part of the block. It pulled on the block so hard. So the block plate or mid plate, depending on what you want to call it, is designed to have a more secure mounting point in the back of the engine to allow the engine to like not cause the chassis to deform the engine block is its purpose. So that's for those of you that don't know. A couple other things you got to worry about when putting a block plate or a mid plate in is the material is very thin. It does a great job of pulling the twist out of stuff, but it doesn't do a good job of holding the engine forward. You got to keep in mind that, you know, engine transmission weight, you know, you're 600 pounds ish with given with this thing with the turbocharger, the header all attached to the engine itself. When you pull, you know, a G and a half or two G's, you're putting 1,200 pounds worth of, or more, at least 1,200 pounds worth of load against this plate, and it's a 90,000 thick steel plate, so the plate will deform. So I am running the mid plate along with the factory style motor mount with a urethane bushing. That'll hold the engine forward. And then the mid plate will do the job of pulling the twist out of the load points on the block. A lot of guys would run a motor plate like this, a mid plate like this, and then a front motor plate as well, and then run a limiter, and the limiter would basically be like a heim of some sort. I've seen people use even like chain or cable, but something to basically bolt to the engine block and bolt forward to the frame rail to hold the engine forward under acceleration. So yeah, this video, I'm gonna call it quits for now. It's getting kind of long. The next video will be, I'll finish up putting this block plate in and talk more or show you more about the install.